So hello and welcome to You Matter. My name's Ned Burwell. I'm your host and the founder of You Matter. Today I'm here with my friend Gail. Welcome, Gail.
Thank you, Ned.
Thanks for agreeing to do this interview.
Oh, it's my pleasure. And I'm very honored to be asked. Thank you.
No, you're most welcome. Gail is not only a friend, but she's a mentor in my life. And our friendship is very dear to me.
Yeah.
So again, it's quite an honor to be here with you today. So tell me a little bit about yourself, Gail.
Wow. Well, I live in Woodstock with my wonderful husband, my family. I have three children and six grandchildren, who I absolutely adore. I've spent a lifetime of, great experiences. My father was in the Canadian military growing up, while I was growing up, and so we lived from one part. I'm from the East Coast originally, so where my family are, my relatives are. We've lived from the East to the West, as well as living in Europe for 4 years. And so one of the greatest experiences of my life has been, I think I've had a lifelong experience of learning about people, about different cultures, about different ways of thinking, different ways of doing things. And I think it's really enriched my life and informed my life. In my work life, I've had a very rich work life. I've worked with people with intellectual disabilities. I've worked in the Big Brother, Big Sister movement with families and children and volunteers. And I worked as in employment counseling also for many years. So I've had wonderfully deep and amazing relationships that I've been able to build that have really given me so much learning and informed me so much. I have to say I feel very blessed in my life. So, as well, I marry people and I bury people, and mostly I just love people.
So the topic we've chose to talk about, or Gail chose to talk about, is compassion and kindness. So tell me about your experiences with that.
Well, Ned, I think compassion and kindness are two of the most critical parts of our humanity. And I think they are simple, they don't cost money. You don't need training to learn them. You don't have to have somebody pay to have it happen. It's a natural, intrinsic part of ourselves. And through my life, and there's a few years there, through my life, I believe very strongly that I have had success based on the kindness of many people, the compassion that I have received in difficult times or in good times, depending on. That those moments, those have been teachable moments for me to grow and recognize the gift I've been given in that moment. Sometimes it's been the gift I really needed in that moment. And so I really believe strongly that we're so caught up with so many things in today's world that seem to be important, but kindness and compassion doesn't seem to be on people's lips as much as it should be.
And what do you suppose takes us away from that kindness and compassion that we need to receive and to give?
Yes, yeah, we do. Well, for one, I think that right now, especially, the world's in a very negative place. There's so many negative things going on in the world which frighten people and scare people and make people feel uncertain. And so it's much easier for people to go to a place of fear, a place of judgment, place of placing high expectations on people or places or things that in other days they may not actually welcome those pieces at all. And I think for myself, social media, for example, is another place where it's very interesting. You know, I see lots of posts with, visuals and stuff that talk about kindness and compassion, and people share them, and it's wonderful. And then sometimes you get a thread of something that starts off positive. If you start reading the threads of things, people get attacked and people go to negative places, and the calling names the people they don't even know, and the judgment and the expectation comes out, and it becomes absolutely debilitating, painful, hurtful, and mean.
That's
just
right.
Just mean spirited. And when it doesn't have to be, right? So why are people choosing to be judgmental? Why are people looking for the name? Why are people looking to cut each other up? And I think for myself, a big part of that comes from their own lack of love for themselves, their own loss of hope around their situation, perhaps, or could be personal to themselves. I think that they feel better about themselves if they feel superior, if they can be negative with people. I think somehow some people think it's a sign of intelligence, because compassion doesn't always sound very intelligent. It doesn't have to.
So when people are what's taking us away from being compassionate and kind, it's, you figure it's a void in what we have in ourselves. It's an issue that we're having with ourselves.
Yes.
Is that sort of what you...
I think that's the core of it. I think the core of it is that people are either self-centered, self-serving. Many people are narcissistic. We see lots of that in the world today. But I also think that they are also not kind to themselves. So, and that projects forward. So if people don't respect themselves and value themselves and care for themselves, how do they in turn see the value in other people? And they're afraid, most people are afraid for other people to see their vulnerability. If I am a person who feels like I'm not very smart, I don't want you to know that. So my way of not showing that is I will come out with some smart comment that might be hurtful to you, but somehow in there you'll be impressed that I have that wisdom to be able to put you down. That's not what's achieved, but there's some kind of philosophy around that, I believe. I think that people, we're so caught up in a world where we think we have to be perfect.
So we're critical and we're judging ourselves, and it's the negativity towards ourselves that is turning off our ability to be compassionate.
To be compassionate and kind.
Where does tolerance fit into this?
Well, I think tolerance is part of both of those things. We don't all have to agree in this world. We don't have to accept everything. We don't have to own everyone else's belief system or way of doing things. But we can respect and tolerate other people's ways as doing something different, other choices. We don't learn in a world where everyone thinks the same. So tolerance becomes a strength by being able to hear and to listen and to pay attention to that which is happening, which either opens the doorway then to compassion or kindness, or it opens the doorway to judgment, anger, frustration, negative. So you can go either way with that. But tolerance is often the base between where choices get made.
So. And in tolerance, we sort of pause or surrender the self. We just let go of the mind for a minute and just let go of our own position.
Yes, yes. Ego's a very difficult thing. And so many people have to work very hard at sustaining their own ego. Very often people will do that, really don't love themselves in the same way that their ego might imply. In fact, they project that they have an ego in order to hide their vulnerabilities or their perceived weaknesses. People who are able to live in the absence of ego or without needing to have that ego nurtured and admired and fluffed up, for
That's
want
right.
of a better word, people who can live in that place will have more tolerance, will have more compassion and kindness, because it's not about them, it's about the situation.
So why do we need compassion? Why do we need kindness?
Well, I fear for a world that has no compassion or kindness. If we have the absence of kindness and compassion, I believe we lose amongst the best parts of our humanity, our capacity to love, they are completely attached to love. And whether it's love for self or love for one another, love for community, love for your family, love, many, many kinds of loves that we enjoy. But if we don't have that capacity, we can't engage in love.
That's right. And you're a person who openly loves their community, mm-hmm. loves themselves. I see that from you in our interactions. What brought you to that in your life?
Lots of learning, because I have not always been a person who loved myself, and I think I spent a good part of my growing years and early adult years especially being very self-judgmental, being very self-conscious, being sure that I wasn't good enough, that I was not enough, period, that I was not smart enough, that I wasn't funny enough, although I can be very funny. The message sometime, I at that time used to think it came from the rest of the world, but I realized a lot of those messages actually came from myself. And when I finally had that realization that it's not someone else saying that to me, it's me saying that to me, and I'm projecting that expectation onto other people that they should think that way about me, I started to finally come to terms with the fact that I was harming myself more. That, and I was also not able to demonstrate that to my children or the people that mattered to me, the importance of them accepting themselves, to enjoy themselves kindness. We all need to show ourselves kindness, mm-hmm. to be good to each other. And it's not to be confused with self-care, because self-care is a whole other, and many people today are looking at self-care in their lives. Self-care has a whole different persona around it. That's a whole different topic area. Mm-hmm. But self-love and mm-hmm. self-respect, self-valuing is incredibly important. That's that peace within yourself that says, you know what, it doesn't matter that I'm heavy. It doesn't matter that my hair is a different color. It doesn't matter if I speak with an accent. It doesn't matter, because I'm a good person and I know that. And I like who I am. I don't need to change for anyone. So that compassion and kindness within yourself allows you then to see it in other people, to be sensitive to other people's when they need that. And there are so many things that you see around where you see people not showing compassion to people who truly need it. Instead, they meet with judgment. And it's, for me, that's very painful to watch or painful to hear about.
So that's a mindset that you've abandoned from your life?
Yeah, I feel that I've worked hard to abandon it. I really hope that I don't go back to it, and maybe I might have someone call me on that. I'm human. I might have, but I really, really try hard not to be judgmental, not to put my expectations onto someone else. And that, it's work. It's mm-hmm. not like it's easy. It's not like we just, it's just sunshine and roses and unicorns and all of that lovely stuff. It's work. Your belief systems require work. How you see the world and engage in the world requires work. And you have to be mindful. You have to be honest. And you have to be willing to show your vulnerability order to do that. So,
how do we inspire the community to practice more compassion and more kindness? What advice would you say to the viewers to inspire them?
Wow, that's a great question. I think as a community, if we take off our ears that listen to all the negatives, that are hearing all the difficult things that are happening, and turn off the TV, stop reading the newspapers, put down the cell phones a bit, and formulate your own ideas, formulate your own thoughts. Don't think the way other people are trying to make you think. I truly believe that there are people in the world who are moving us away from compassion and kindness in the way that we approach people in the world. So if we can adopt for ourselves a belief system that I'm not going to join that. A simple kindness, a simple act of compassion could make a whole different situation, a healthier, more durable, more renewing experience than an act of hurting someone when the choice is so simple. So in community can grow in kindness and compassion by hearing voices that are being spoken, by reading people's situations, by truly embracing people in a whole way, lumps, bumps, and all. Because all of us have bad points, all of us have good points, all of us have moments where we are a great person, we also have moments of weakness when we're not our best self. You know, that's part of our humanity. But if we can be embraced with all of it, then we have been given the gift of kindness, compassion, and tolerance, as you mentioned as well.
That's right. So to wrap it up in the most concise way, what is the fastest and most direct route to embracing compassion and kindness?
I think the fastest way is to go within. Every person is responsible for themselves. You don't have to follow other people. You follow yourself within. And by loving yourself, by accepting yourself, who you are, by embracing the gift that you are in this world to other people, self leads you. The path of love is so much easier and makes so much more sense.
So we turn inward, celebrate ourselves, and
then we can turn outward.
And then turn outward.
And you can bring that love to other people. You can bring that acceptance. When you're not so busy judging yourself, you don't have to judge other people. You can see the benefit of not doing that, right? And the richness of that. And I think bottom line, when we look at the capacity we have as human beings, that is one of the greatest gifts we can give to ourselves, is to stop all the head chat and the negative self-talk, which people do all the time, whether they're willing to acknowledge it or not, we do it. And just let that go to the silence and hear your heart, hear the goodness in you, and accept that.
Wonderful. Thank you, Gail.
You're welcome,
Ned. It was great to have you on You Matter.
Thank you, Ned. I love you.